तो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद उत्तरा फाल्गुनी नक्षत्र. एंड उत्तरा फाल्गुनी इज द स्टार विच इंडिकेट्स द कंडीशन आफ्टर होली एज वी लर्न्ड बिफोर द प्रीवियस क्लास ऑफ पूर्वा फाल्गुनी इटसेल्फ. वी लर्न्ड दैट पूर्वा फाल्गुनी एंड उत्तरा फाल्गुनी इंडिकेट्स द कंडीशन बिफोर होली एंड आफ्टर होली. So what happens after Holi is the end of the month. After Holi, there will be some 15 days for the month to go, for the year to end. And then there will be the start of the new year with the Chaitra Navratri. Same thing is indicated by Uttara Falguni itself. The signification of the planet, whichever is in Uttara Falguni, is present there from childhood. But in the middle part of life, the thing is completely gone, not available. And then after crossing middle part of life, that signification may come back. It does indicate a scenario. For an example, if you take Mars or the fourth lord, taking fourth lord, if the fourth lord is in Uttara Falguni, what do I want to explain? Ending and a new beginning. What do I want to explain is that if the fourth lord is in Uttara Falguni, in that scenario, the person will have all the happiness of home and property because of his father, mother, or other ancestors in the starting part of the life. But in the middle part of the life, either his parents will lose the property, or he will not be able to enjoy that property as he will have to leave his birthplace to for studies or some other purpose. And then the person will not return back to enjoy the properties of their fathers, but will make their own property. So it is an indicative of things which are present by starting by the grace of God. And in the middle part of life, that particular signification is lost. And that comes back after crossing a significant portion in life. For an example, if Venus or seventh lord is there, then right from the childhood, the person is all engulfed with women and ladies. In the middle part of the life, he may leave a life like a bachelor, depriving for relationships, yearning for relationships. And by the end part of life, after crossing 28, 29 or 30, he will get the company of woman once again. So this is what is indicated by the fact that 15 days after Holi, the year ends and it starts with a new year, with Chaitra Navratri. That is the first thing that I will want to explain. And I'm explaining it in a very illustrative way. And you need to understand this particular stuff. And then you have to use it, right? I don't want to tell you the result of all the planets in this particular nakshatra. Right? So it is about understanding. You have to take the understanding and then apply it accordingly, right? Telling the results for all the planets, for all the aspects is not feasible, not possible. There was a question yesterday that we haven't recorded. So to answer that, generally these results of mantra and the results of stories is applicable to all the planet. You just use a little bit of story and then you will be able to understand. Right. The result of different padas, the result of birth in different padas in Uttara Falguni is only applicable to the ascendant nakshatra or moon nakshatra. So the stories and mantras are applicable to all the planet which is in Uttara Falguni, whereas the result of different padas of Uttara Falguni is only applicable if the moon or the lagna is in any pada of Uttara Falguni. But still, even in that, when I tell you the result for different padas, I tell you, you know, that this person will be angry, or this person will be this way, or this person can be that way. So that can also be intelligently used for other planets, right? So whichever result you can apply for planets, you should apply it for planets. And whichever result you cannot apply for a planet, you cannot understand how to apply for a planet, leave it as a result which is to be told if the moon or the ascendant is in this particular nakshatra. Getting my point? I think that is pretty clear, right? If you can apply, apply it. If you can't apply, leave it. This is the way it works, right? This is the way any part of knowledge works. If you can understand it, use it. If you can't understand it, leave it. Watch the video after 1 year. Maybe you can understand it in a better way. I use all the information in prediction in one way or the other. But you as a students may have some difficulty in the starting, right? But don't worry, note it down. And in near future, you will be able to do that, right? You will be able to do that. There is no problem related to that, right? And the things are easy to understand, right? Just don't pressurize your mind so much. It is very easy to be understood, right? Like lost in the middle part of life is something, you know, the signification of, like, for an example, take money. Like, take if the moon or the second lord or the 11th lord is there in Uttara Falguni, then what does that mean? That person is born in a rich family. But in the middle part of life, when he starts his career, etc., he will have to struggle for money. But after spending considerable time in his profession, say by the age of 40, 45, he will be able to start acquiring money once again, right? This aspect of Uttara Falguni comes with the fact that one pada of Uttara Falguni falls in Leo and other three padas falls in Virgo. So Uttara Falguni is a mix of Leo Virgo, right? Coming to the shloka now, right? Because the before Holi and after Holi thing I have already described, right? And nakshatras related to a particular deity, and nakshatras related to a particular vrata, nakshatra related to a particular story. Right now, we are covering the Vedic stories, stories given in Vedas and Puranas, sorry, Vedas and Upanishads. We are not covering the stories, like, let me tell you one very particular thing. This will be a bit off topic, but just be with me if you want to understand the grandeur of this particular knowledge. So Mula is told to be ruled by Nirutti. And it is told that you should worship the deities related to the nakshatras. So if someone is born in Mula, or for an example, if someone is born in Uttara Falguni, he should have to worship Bhaga. Now we don't worship Bhaga now. Do we worship Bhaga? Do you have any god named Bhaga in your temple? You don't have. Neither you know the temples of Bhaga. But when we do Yajna, there can be some mantras for Bhaga as well, which either even Pandits don't understand. But generally speaking, we don't worship Bhaga nowadays. So in the Pushyamitra Shunga period, in the period of Pushyamitra Shunga, the gods that are there in Vedas and the gods that we use, that we worship now, have been changed, considerably changed, extremely changed, right? So the Uttara Falguni ruled by Bhaga is one part. Nowadays, in today's world, if I have to see who is the lord of Uttara Falguni, then I have to understand what is Bhaga. Bhaga is the dispenser of affection. And Bhaga is a presiding deity, presiding form of sun over love and marriage. And he is the dispenser of affection, right? So Bhaga can be easily replaced by Katyayani, right? And we worship Katyayani nowadays, but we don't worship Bhaga, right? So that is an altogether different aspect of the modern deities and how they can be correlated to a particular nakshatra. And that is a very deep part. So maybe a series later on this particular part as well, right, or some webinar on this particular thing. But this is something that needs to be understood, right? Nakshatra knowledge is very deep. Okay. Going further, coming to the mantra of Uttara Falguni, Bhagasyottare Vetvaha Prastadva Samana Avastad. As I told you, Uttara Falguni is ruled by Bhaga. And Bhaga is a, as I told you yesterday also, Aditya or Sun have multiple forms. Sun also have multiple avatars and multiple incarnations. and one of the incarnation of sun is Bhagavan, who is the dispenser of affection and who is a presiding deity over love and marriage. So first of all, Uttara Falguni Nakshatra indicates affection. So people born in Uttara Falguni Nakshatras are affectionate, and whichever planet is in Uttara Falguni Nakshatra, you have to be affectionate related to the signification of that planet. You have to be careful related to the signification of that planet. You have to be loving related to the signification of that planet. Point one, generally, whichever planet is in Uttara Falguni related to the signification of that planet, the person is very caring and very lovable. The person have very modest approach, and the person have very good feelings related to that particular planet. So if it is Sun, then this person is having very soft qualities of dominance, very soft qualities of, you know, playing politics. Very finer aspect of it is indicated by Uttara Falguni, right? Whichever planet is in Uttara Falguni, the finer aspect of that thing is there. For an example, if Venus is in Uttara Falguni, then the finer aspect of love is there. So it can be a completely platonic love, right? It will indicate a finer, an affectionate, a loving quality of that particular thing only. If there is Mars in Uttara Falguni, then it is not a person who will try to fight much, but he is a person whose sense of fight is only motivated by the sense of protecting the loved ones. It is not a person who will get easily angry, but it is a person who will only get angry when his loved ones are under distressed condition, right? So Uttara Falguni indicates coming out of very softer, very finer, very delicate tendencies of the planet, whichever is in Uttara. Uttara Falguni. Second thing is Uttara Falguni is related to marriage. It is the form, as I told you before, it is the form of Aditya, it is the form of sun god which rules over love and marriage. So planet Uttara Falguni Nakshatra affects your love life, affects your marital life to a very great extent. If the seventh lord or Venus is there, then love, affection and relationship is very important in your life. If there are other planets, then that thing is particularly very important in your love life. For an example, if Sun is there, then the approval of the parents and the power can be important in your love life. If the Moon is there, then mental solace and common likes and dislikes can be a very strong factor. If Mars is there, then working for each other, coming to each other's help, sexuality can be a very strong factor. If Mercury is there, then learning, intellectual level, thinking on the same plane is a, you know, like is something very important related to the relationships. If Jupiter is there, then intellectual understanding, you know, religion, believing in the same guru, believing in the same god, having same morals is something important in relationship. If Venus is there, in that scenario, the luxuries, the life standard, the society, etc., is something very crucial in your marriage or in your love relationships, and so on and so forth, right? If Rahu is there, then Rahu indicates cheating. So this person is gonna be cheated in their marital life, right? If Ketu is there, then Ketu indicates a tendency where you are not happy with the spouse, but you also cannot leave the spouse. So if Ketu is in Uttara Falguni, in that scenario, person generally gets stuck in a relationship which they don't want to continue, but at the same point of time, they cannot come out of the relationship as well. Right. So the planet in Uttara Falguni is very crucial. That indicates three things basically. That indicates what happens with you in a relationship or in a marriage. Point one, the outcome of the relationship and marriage. If Rahu is there, then cheating is the outcome, for example. Right. It also indicates it will also indicate the most important aspect. Most important aspect in your relationship. Right, so if you have like say Sun in the Uttara Falguni, in that scenario, getting the approval of the parents, your spouse not being egoistic, your spouse being able to dominate over people is one of the main qualities that you will look for in a spouse, one of the main factors that will influence the choice of spouse or choice of partner in the life of this particular person. If Uttara Falguni is afflicted, then marital life is bad. If Uttara Falguni is not afflicted, then marital life is not bad. Then marital life is generally good, satisfactory, or at least love and affection is there. If Uttara Falguni is afflicted, if Uttara Falguni is having malefic planets in that scenario, your spouse may stop loving you after a particular point of time. If Uttara Falguni is not afflicted, then even though other factors lead to a break in marriage, still in that scenario, there is love in marriage. Getting my point? This is something that you need to understand. So Pratulji is giving us a feedback that, sir, I know a person who has sun and moon both in Uttara Falguni. His parents fight a lot. Even fist though, fight, but yes, Pratulji.
Sir, fist fights tak ho jati hai. Oh, sorry, typo ho gaya tha wahan pe. Sorry. तो फिस्ट फाइट तो हो जाती है, बट दे वो कभी एक दूसरे को ना छोड़ते नहीं है. मतलब उनको बोलो कि इतना लड़ाई कर क्यों कर रहे हो, डाइवोर्स ले लो, नहीं लेंगे.
अफेक्शन अफेक्शन इज देयर इन उत्तर फाल्गुनी, सो सन एंड मून इज देयर, सो देयर इज अफेक्शन बिटवीन पेरेंट्स एंड देयर इज अफेक्शन टुवर्ड्स पेरेंट्स, बोथ द थिंग इज देयर. सो इवन द चाइल्ड विल नॉट लीव दैट फैमिली वेयर पेरेंट्स आर फाइटिंग, नाइदर पेरेंट्स विल सेपरेट.
ट्रू इज
बिकॉज द चाइल्ड कैन आल्सो लीव द यू टू पीपल कीप फाइटिंग, आई एम गोइंग. That can also be an approach, right? So affection towards the parents and affection between the parents, both things are there. This is a live example of how you should be extending this particular knowledge, and extension is very easy, right? And why I'm teaching you in this way, where you will have to use your mind for the extension so that it increases your mental power, right? Otherwise, spoon feeding will lead you nowhere, okay? So we understood this particular aspect of Uttara Falguni, right? 6-7 nakshatras affect marriage very strongly, as we saw on Pushya, Ashwini, etc., Bharani, and all of them, all of them have a very different aspect of love. Bharani was the sense of being fulfilled. So if Bharani is afflicted by malefics, in that scenario, you know, in your love life, in your relationship, you may not feel fulfilled. You will be like, you know, like love is there, everything is there, but I'm not gaining anything from this particular relationship if Bharani is afflicted, right? Uttara Falguni indicates the sense of affection. So if Uttara Falguni is afflicted, then you will be like, you know, like love is all, like affection is not there. Although this person is giving me money, this person is doing everything, this person is keeping me happy, giving me money for my own expenditure, giving me money for the family and everything. But love and affection is not there, right? So all the nakshatras, whichever are significant for marriage. For an example, Ashwini was also a significant for marriage, and Ashwini indicated that particular aspect of, you know, having a child through marriage. Right, or coming of the lady for marriage. This was the same thing with Purva Falguni, right? Purva Falguni indicated coming of the lady for marriage, right? As I told you, Jaya means the one who was bring forth, the one who is bring forth. So Purva Falguni indicates that particular aspect of who is coming up for marriage. So when Purva Falguni is afflicted, you are supposed to make a wrong choice. I told this in the previous class also. So there are 6-7 nakshatras which indicate marriage, and they indicate different aspects of marriage. And the knowledge of nakshatra is just to make yourself better to understand that this particular thing, this particular enjoyment is not there in this particular chart. So if you want to go through a happy marital life, you should ignore this particular thing. For an example, if there is a planet in Uttara Falguni, then you know. If there is a malefic planet in Uttara Falguni, then you know there will be no love and affection in the marriage, right? So for such person, if they want to have a happy marital life, they should learn to ignore the aspect of affection and should take marital life only as duty. That it is a duty and we have to compromise and we have to make a couple so that we can take care of our child and can give them good education, etc., right? This is the way to succeed. Nakshatras will indicate you the way to succeed. Nakshatras will indicate you the way of enjoyment. Nakshatras will indicate the way of satisfaction, right? So this is, you know, all the 27 nakshatras indicate different aspects of marriage, different aspects of child, different aspects of profession. And you have to analyze every nakshatra. If there is a planet in that nakshatra, then that particular quality is significant. right? So if there is a planet in Uttara Falguni, then affection in marriage is significant. For this person, affection in marriage is significant. Now, if there is a malefic, then for this person, affection in marriage is significant and he's not getting that. If there is a benefic, then for this person, affection in marriage is significant and he's getting that, right? So it is in this particular way. And the word is bhagashyottare, behtavah. Uttare means later on. And that is what also comes from the word Uttara Falguni. So as I told you, the Purva nakshatras indicate the results which the karma which have been committed long before. And now you can only get the result, either good or bad, from that nakshatra, and you cannot change anything related to that nakshatra. Whereas in Uttara Falguni, because it is a Uttara nakshatra, it will unfold itself in future. So you have all the rights or all the controls on your karma to make it better. And for this particular thing, it is needed to advise the child. So when you see the horoscope of someone who is 12, 13, 14 years old and you see a malefic planet in Uttara Falguni, you can tell them that for you, relationships are not very good. So in your life, never cheat a lady or never do wrong in a relationship, right? And if they consciously look at it, not to cheat in a relationship, etc., if they consciously control this particular instinct, then they are supposed to have a very good life. Now, you cannot do it for a 30 years old guy. If you see a horoscope of a 30-year-old person having a malefic planet in Uttara Falguni, now you cannot say control yourself and you will get a good result. Because the most significant part of the life, the starting part of the life, he have already gone through. And maybe he have done sins or he have done bad karma in that particular part of life. What I just want to say is that all the Uttara nakshatras right now, for the case Uttara Falguni, does indicate that your karma in this life itself will decide the result. So so in all the Uttara nakshatras, you have the complete choice of changing the karma today and getting a good result tomorrow. So even if someone is 30, 35 years old, having a malefic Uttara Falguni nakshatra, and he have cheated a few people in relationships before, or he have been mean in a relationship before, or he have been, you know, like greedy in a relationship before, not an issue. The thing have been done, but still right from this moment, if they start improving themselves, if they leave their bad habits and start being honest, devoted and faithful in the relationship, then in future, after 10-20 years in their old age, they will have good results related to relationships, good results related to marriage, good results related to partnership, right?
सर एक फीडबैक है सर एक जातक है उसका उसका मून उत्तर फागुनी में ही है तो आपने जैसे था ना भी अफेक्शन वाली बात तो उसने ना करा था उसने रिलेशनशिप में चीट किया था ठीक है लेकिन बाद में जाके माफी अगर मांगा तो उसके पार्टनर ने हाँ बोल दिया कि ठीक है माफ के अफेक्शन है अभी भी वो चीज है और वो चीट वाली बात भी सही बैठती है
ये जो particular the thing and again Uttara Falguni when you realize that it is my problem and you go and you say sorry you still have the chance to change the karma for Purva Falguni this is not the case so even if you realize that it was my mistake and you say sorry the person is like sorry I have overdone I got married so I cannot do anything right? So this is the particular difference between Purva Falguni and Uttara Falguni that in Uttara Falguni even when you realize the mistake after 10 years, you still have some chance to rectify your karma. Whereas in Purva Nakshatras, you don't get any chance to rectify it. Thanks for the feedback. Uttara Falguni mantra, the second word is Behtavah, which means there is a strong carrying flow, strong carrying of flow, strong flow of current in Uttara Falguni Nakshatra. Which does indicate that whichever planet is in Uttara Falguni Nakshatra, the significations of that planet are very strong. very strong to overpower the life of the person, very strong to overpower all the aspect of the person's personality. So for an example, when Moon is in Uttara Falguni for the particular case which Pratul is talking about, this person is strongly influenced by the significations of Moon. So the person can be strongly artistic, the person can be strongly emotional, the person can be strongly devoted to Krishna, the person can be strongly influenced by Moon, the person can be strongly influenced towards money, right? So whichever planet is in Uttara Falguni, the current of the planet, the nature of the planet, the quality of that planet is very prominent, right? Like for many people, there will be no planet in the ascendant. In those charts, such nakshatras whose results are very strong are important, right? Whichever planet is in Uttara Falguni, the look of the person, the nature of the person, the personality of the person will be like that planet only.
फीडबैक दे रहा हूँ जो आपने बोला ना सारे पॉइंट वो सही हैं. वो पर्सन एक तो द्वारका जी द्वारकाधीश हैं उनको काफी मानते हैं तो कृष्ण का फॉर्म. दैट पर्सन इज अ ग्राफिक डिजाइनिंग उसको थोड़ा आता है तो वो पार्ट टाइम पे करता है तो आर्ट आ गया. एंड दैट पर्सन इज इन्वॉल्व इन द स्टॉक मार्केट तो मनी ओरिएंटेड सो दैट इज ऑल्सो क्वाइट ट्रू.
ऑल्दो स्टॉक शुड बी टेकन फ्रॉम मून इज माय पर्सनल एडवाइस. Why? Because Moon indicates fluctuating source of everything. Like fluctuate, Moon indicates all fluctuating, right? 15 days on the rise and 15 days on the decrease. So anything where there is no guarantee is indicated by Moon. So stock market is a type of, you know, income where the income is not guaranteed. You can gain for all the 15 days and you can lose for all the 15 days. So the source of income which is fluctuating is also indicated by Moon. So yeah, stocks also come under the influence of Moon. Many people wrongly take stocks for Mercury. God save them for the predictions. It is Moon which should be taken. Right? So Uttara Falguni is strong carrying flow, and whichever planet is in Uttara Falguni, the nature, the significations, the qualities, the attributes of that planet is very prominent on the person. Right? So if it is Mars, then the person is like Mars. That is a very thin waist, a broad shoulder, angry, etc. And Uttara Falguni, the third important word in Uttara Falguni is Bhagashyotre Bhatavah Parastadohamana Avastad. He is conveying wishes. So there is a very peculiar trait with Uttara Falguni. Uttara Falguni person, or you know, the planet in Uttara Falguni generally helps other people realize what they want in that particular area. For an example, if you have Venus, then you are one of the person who helps people understand what they want in a relationship or what they want in sexuality. If you have Mars in Uttara Falguni, then you are a person who make people understand what do you want in your, how do you want to control your anger, or how you can actually control your anger, etc. Right? So whichever planet is in Uttara Falguni, you may not be an expert in the signification of that planet, but you help others realize their motivations and wishes and desires related to that particular planet, right? Other people, by talking to you, get enlightened related to the signification of that planet and how they want it. For an example, if you have Mars in Uttara Falguni, then whenever someone fights with you, in the end, they realize that they are not fighting with a good person, or you are, or they should not fight with you. And even the most angry person, even the most frustrated person will end fighting with you by saying that, sir, I am sorry, by realizing that it is my own mistake, right? So actually, Uttara Falguni indicates the trait of person being able to make others understand what they want, make others understand their plan, or make others, expand their understanding related to the particular signification of the planet, whichever is in Uttara Falguni Nakshatra. The stories of Uttara Falguni are very too many. That's why I have quickly jumped over it. So as you know, Uttara Falguni is ruled by Bhaga. And why Bhaga is called Bhaga? So first of all, Bhaga means the female reproductive organ also. One particular portion of that organ is known as bhaga. Bhaga means the one who is served by Bhagirathi. Bhagirathi is a sister of Ganga. Right? So Bhagirathi, bhaga means the one who is served by Bhagirathi. Right? So bhaga or the nakshatra Uttra Falguni is served by emotions. The nakshatra Uttra Falguni is fueled by emotions. The motivation of the planet in Uttara Falguni is fueled and shaped by emotions. Point one. Right? Bhaga Uttara Falguni Nakshatra is very good for money, is very good for fame, is very good for affluence, and is very good for spiritual development as well. Right? Uttara Falguni Nakshatra indicates the darkness of Brahma Muhurta, the darkness before sunrise. So whichever planet is in Uttara Falguni, the person may start as a very may start very disappointed in the significations of that planet, and later on will have many good results related to that planet. What do I actually mean? Suppose you have seventh lord in Uttara Falguni, then in your school time you have no girlfriend. And people, your parents are worried that you will be able to get married or not. But after, passing college, you are all surrounded up by women only. So that is what I mean when I say the darkness before sunrise kind of stuff, right? So if you have your 10th lord in Uttara Falguni, then up to your college time, everyone is worried that will this person be able to work? He will not be able to do anything. He will just be wasting our money and time. He's not intelligent. But after crossing the college, you will show very phenomenal traits of improvement. That is indicated by Uttara Falguni. And as I already told you, it is a nakshatra for love and affection. There is a particular thing that I have written in my copy. Jaise andhkar vinashak surya bhag dhava prithvi ki jyoti pahunchata hai, usi prakar se he vivahit purush, bhag ko kya bola hai, vivahit purush. In the same manner, O married man, the bhaga, tu mata pita ko sukh pahuncha. So, the bhaga or Uttara Falguni is very much devoted to giving satisfaction, giving happiness to elders. Getting my point? This is indicated by Uttara Falguni. So, whichever planet is in Uttara Falguni, you never go out of the track, or you never go out of the, out of the customs and traditions related to the signification of that planet. Whichever planet is in Uttara Falguni, your developments in the signification of that planet, your developments regarding the signification of that planet is always under the good check of religion and how your parents wanted it to be. Like, for an example, if the seventh lord is in Purva Falguni, then this person, even if he does a love marriage, it will be the same caste love marriage. It will not be inter-caste love marriage or inter-religion love marriage, right? So, Uttara Falguni always gives happiness to parents, right? So, even if there is a Mars in Uttara Falguni or there is the third lord in Uttara Falguni, then even the anger of the person or even the, risk-taking ability of the person is supported by their parents only. Like, their parents feel that the thing on which this person got angry was right. Right? So the support of parents and the support of elders is something that is indicated by Uttara Falguni. Right? So it is a peculiar case where your father is your best buddy in impressing that particular lady that you wanted. One of the rare nakshatras which doesn't generally happen. And I have written multiple synonyms, right? So it indicates fortune. Like, Uttara Falguni indicates fortune, beauty, the female reproductive organ. It indicates dharma. It indicates that particular part of the sky which is worth worshipping. So people worship Uttara Falguni for their might because he is worthy of worship in that particular area, whichever planet is in Uttara Falguni. Bhag also indicates the juice of earth. Water below earth is indicated by Uttara Falguni. Right? But you know, Bhag is Bhag, the lord of Uttara Falguni, is told as a blind person. He is told as an Andha, which means that whichever planet is in Uttara Falguni Nakshatra, in the signification of that planet, you are not able to take very good calculative decision. You are not able to have very good calculative decisions. Your decisions related to the planet which is in Uttara Falguni Nakshatra, your decisions related to that planet may be wrong, at least in the starting. Right? It indicates the lack of foresight. Right? So, Bhaga will indicate getting into commitment with a lady without thinking whether you actually like her or not. Right? So, mistaking an attraction for love and making commitments, etc. Such short-sighted decisions are indicated by all those things in astrology which are termed as blind, and Bhaga, the lord of Uttara Falguni, is one of the nakshatra which is termed as blind. Right? So Bhaga is a form of Aditya. Bhaga is also an avatar of Shiva. It indicates fortune. It indicates wealth, specifically wealth gained through inheritance. It indicates affluence. It indicates fame. It indicates beauty. It indicates love. It indicates sexuality. It indicates female reproductive organ. It indicates dharma. It indicates trying for something again and again. It indicates the desire of not engaging with something, or it indicates laziness. It indicates fatigue. Okay, it is beautiful, it is powerful, it have all the physical prowess and all the physical qualities that is important to achieve something. Along with that, Purva Falguni want to be all-rounder, he want to learn multiple things, he is not focused on one particular thing. It does indicate someone who is, like a jack of all, master of none kind of a scenario. Right? This is the different stories about Purva Falguni. See, I have written this big paragraph for it that I may not be able to explain. So, just a few basic points. Okay. Now coming to the remedies and the result of different padas and Purva Falguni. So as you know, Bhaga, as I told you, Bhaga is sevit by Bhagirathi. You know, every Sankranti or every Purnima, you should have dip in at least one holy river. So that is one of the remedies that I will recommend, first of all. Worshipping, using water in your worship every day, and if possible, mixing Ganga Jal to that particular water is a very good remedy for Uttara Falguni. Using water to, sprinkle on the puja room, sprinkle in the home, or using water in Achaman, etc. Like 80% of the people, I am very sure that when they do puja, they don't do Achaman. Right. But if you want to remedy Uttara Falguni, then Achaman is an important aspect and you should look into it, right? And at least taking bath in a holy river at least once a year or twice or two times per year is something that I will say is a very recommended remedy for Uttara Falguni. In Purva Falguni video, I have given 3-4 remedies for all the nakshatras ruled by sun. And Uttara Falguni is once again ruled by sun, the Bhaga form of sun. Bhag, technically Bhagani, Bhag form of sun. So remedies from that section particularly can also be used. Right. And for prem, for relationship, giving itr to Devi temple on Fridays, giving itr to Devi temple on Friday is a very strong remedy. Itr doesn't mean perfume. Okay. So giving itr to Devi temple every Friday, starting from a Friday, is a very good remedy for love and relationship issues, and can be very effectively used for remedying Uttara Falguni. And Pratulji had one more feedback that I haven't, that missed out of my eyes, but I can see it right now, that there was a guy having Venus in Uttara Falguni. He was hated by every girl in school due to his goon kind of activities, but he is now fashion designer surrounded by models. So this particular thing of this particular trait comes.
सर आई हैव वन मोर फीडबैक. अभी आपने बोला ना कि जमीन के नीचे का पानी होता है उत्तर फागुनी. सो आई हैव अ गाय, उसका घर जो है ना, उसके घर के पीछे ना इतना ज्यादा पानी जमा है कि वो धीमे धीमे करके ना नीचे मतलब उसके घर पे सीलन आ चुकी है. तो वो कहता है कि मेरे तो, मैं पता नहीं तालाब के ऊपर रहता हूँ. मतलब उसका एक स्टेटमेंट था कि मैं, मेरा घर जमीन पे नहीं है, मेरा घर पानी के ऊपर है. मैं इतना, मेरे घर के पीछे इतना तालाब जमा हुआ है.
So, very connecting, that the point is. Or even if I have to give it for a remedy, I should say you go to Venice. That is a city floating on water. So actually, you know, Pratulji, this particular thing is very important. You know, the small things like you are able to relate it. Maybe other people are not able to relate it. But this particular thing, you know, I was talking to a guy, one of our students, and he told that, Subhamji, what I like in you is that you live astrology, you like eat astrology, you are 24/7 in astrology. The level of astrology is that you should be able to see anything, and you should be able to, you know particularly know that this thing is getting activated by this particular stuff. And although learning it going the Ashtamangal way, and the Ashtamangal astrologer will go out of the home and he will have to reach to the destination where he is supposed to do the prashna, he have to notice everything in between, right? So when I go for an Ashtamangal and I see that my neighbor lady have washed her home and the water is now going below the tires of my car, I understand that in this prashna, the question will be related to marriage and why I am not getting married, because the maximum portion falls in Virgo. And any planet in Virgo Navamsha is a problem in marriage. No matter if he is the seventh lord or not, doesn't matter. It can be seventh lord, it cannot be seventh lord, I don't care. But planet in Virgo Navamsha, problem for marriage. Because Virgo is not going to support the marriage, right? So when these particular things happen, I know that Uttara Falguni is activated. And there will be problem related to two things. 80% of the time, there will be problem related to not getting married because the three padas goes in Virgo. And 20% of the time, the problem will be related to either child, the natural fifth house, or inheritance. Or father, that's or my father is very ailing, very ill, what needs to be done, this particular kind of thing. Right? So that's why, you know, knowing this particular information is very important. Like when we say that Bhaga indicates the Brahma Muhurta time, the time before sunrise. So, you know, when someone drops me a message at 3 in the morning, as people don't know, like someone messaging me from some other country and it reaches to me at 4:15 or 4:30 and I am like by chance awake at that point of time also, and taking my phone and saw that particular message before sunrise, say around 4:30, 4:45, then I know that Uttara Falguni is activated, and there have to be questions related to Uttara Falguni. I have to tell results according to Uttara Falguni, right? So this particular thing is something that we have to take care of, right? And even, you know, like, let me be very honest with you, there are multiple things that you cannot say in front of people. And there are multiple things, you know, there are few things that can only be told to personal students. Like, you know, like for an example, Bhaga and Bharani. These two nakshatras indicate the female reproductive organ, right? We see, taking it like astrology is a male-based science, it is not a female-based stuff. So technically, take it for spouse. So it is also applicable for male. So I always say one particular thing, that when you have a malefic in Bharani or when you have a malefic in this Uttara Falguni, you get a second end spouse. Like he was already in love with someone else, right? And was not given to you. Because that particular relationship broke, this particular person is in front of you, right? And despite loving you throughout the life, the person will always have a deep down desire of that, if I got that lady, my life must have been something else, but she got married somewhere else and I am too. Satisfied with this particular thing, right? This is what is, because you know, it comes to the particular part of, you know, the female reproductive organ. Right? So it is someone attached to some other stuff. Not being able to get that thing, it is now compromising here. If the Uttara Falguni is afflicted or connected in a particular way. But now these are few things which, you know, you cannot say openly. So, you know, for this particular thing, I just like drop a hint like this particular thing, like if you can think over it. Getting up. If you can think over it, what are the senses of it? Right. Generally, such people's spouse, because once again, the female reproductive organ. So if there is a malefic, there have to be problem in the female reproductive organ. Now that problem should not be something medical that you will be able to see, but that can be something non-medical also. For an example, you know, Mars indicates a Viklang spouse. Mars indicates a handicapped spouse. Now generally all of you having Mars in the seventh house don't have a handicapped spouse, first of all. What does that mean? That the spouse is unable to do a particular thing. So maybe unable to produce child, unable to earn money, unable to give their complete into home life, unable in doing one particular thing that is expected from the spouse, be it producing children or earning money or mental support or physical support or emotional support or any such thing, getting my point. So have to understand in an extensive way. The same thing goes with Bhaga, and it will also come with Revati, right? Revati in Kispa. It will also come with Revati, it comes with Bhaga, it also comes with Bharani. This, in one point or the other, indicates the male or female sexual organs, right? And when there are malefics in these nakshatras, there is supposed to be problem with that particular organ, right? And it will result into problem in childbirth. Or if child is there, then child is going to have some or the other problem, health problem, mental problem, physical problem, emotional problem, etc., etc., etc. So how do I come to find out if your child is not going to have a very good upbringing or he's not going to be a very social person? Using this particular thing only. Right? But that is something that cannot be explained over a free class, that cannot be explained openly. And you know, when you teach it, when two people are sitting together and you are teaching it, then it is very okay. Then it is very good. Then you are very free to teach this particular stuff. But you know, telling it over a video is not that easy. But still, me dropping such small hints is for this particular reason, that you open up your mind, you expand your mind and see in how many multiple ways it can work. No? Result for different padas of Uttara Falguni, quickly.
Sir, I just looked up something I remembered. And jaise jo daksh ji ka jo yagya tha, उसमें वीरभद्र जी ने एक देवता का आंख निकाल लिया था, तो उसका नाम भी भगी था।
हाँ, तभी तो भग को अंधा बोला ना बीच में।
अच्छा अच्छा,
इसलिए भग को अंधा बोला, उसकी आंख निकाली गई थी ना भग की। अच्छा, भग की आंख निकालने का मतलब है, सी भग आल्सो इंडिकेट्स फीमेल ऑर्गन, भग मींस फीमेल ऑर्गन, भरनी इज आल्सो फीमेल ऑर्गन, बट यमराज इज, Yamraj was what? His sister was telling, you come and copulate with me, but Yamraj denied. So in Bharani, there is sexuality, and that sexuality is controlled or ignored for the upliftment of the person. So Bharani is the one who will be very much interested in sexuality, but he will not try to save a relationship using sexuality. He will like, okay, if you love me, it is okay. If you don't love me, that is not okay. Or even if this person is getting best of the opportunities for relationship, but if he is offered a job, he will leave the relationship, will go for the job. Because he is having eyes and also having sexuality, there is a balance. Bhag is kamand. Bhag is blind because of that sexuality. That is the significance of, you know, having one eye out. So that does indicate that Uttara Falguni indicates someone who will not progress in one particular part of life because of sexuality. Because of sexuality, because of relationship, because of spouse, because of love, one particular aspect of personality, one particular aspect of life can be underdeveloped or can be completely ignored. Because this person have given very much into the relationship. Right? So, you know, if there is a planet in this Uttara Falguni, and I am giving a consultation, and if I see this particular person, I will say that, you know, like, get, like, my point prime approach will be get out of this particular relationship. Because it is eating up something. Kamand hai na? So, kamand aadmi kya hota hai? The one who is blind with sexuality will ignore either dharma. If he is kamand, if someone is kamand in a gandharva relationship, then he will ignore dharma. If one is kamand for a prostitute, he will ignore artha. If one is kamand for his wife, he will ignore moksha. But kamand, you have to ignore one particular stuff. Right? And what does ignorance mean? That the seed of that particular thing is there, then only then you can ignore. I cannot ignore Shahrukh Khan in this room because Shahrukh Khan is not in the room. Right? If he was there, then there is a question of ignoring. So the seed of that particular thing is there. And Andhata means this particular thing you are not able to realize. Right. So you are very right. That's why we use the particular Andha. But abhi as a result, kyun nahi kehte na, wo kal phir koi comment mein, sir, mere saath to nahi hua sir. Bilkul nahi hua sir. अब कहां सर बैठ के समझाए यार, बताओ आप मुझे, उतने छोटे से फोन में कहां टाइप करता था यार, और आपके पास समय है प्रभु, मैं तो नहीं हूं ना समय के साथ. That have been some problem. Yeah, this is something. Yeah, thank you Arkan ji for this.
Sorry, I was thinking that could you interpret this, you know, could you ये जो स्टोरी है कि वो ये जो भग है वो क्या कहते हैं शिव जी के निंदा में हिस्सा लिया था, इसलिए उसको फिर वीरभद्र ने सजा दी, क्या इसको हम कहते हैं ना जातक के जीवन में ऐसा कुछ थीम आता है इससे संबंधित,
इसको
ऐसा कर सकते हैं?
एक बड़ा देखिए शिव जी, व्हाई ही टॉक्ड बैड ऑफ शिवा, बिकॉज़ इट द थ्री पदास ऑफ द उत्तरा फाल्गुनी विल गो इन वर्गो व्हिच विल बी द डेबिलिटेशन फॉर वीनस. सो द मृत्युंजय फॉर्मेट ऑफ शिवा. But he is not talking bad of Shiva, like what we can take out of the story. He is talking bad for Sati, who is getting debilitated in Virgo. Right? He is talking bad of Sati. He is talking bad of that particular lady. He is not talking bad of Shiva, cosmos. Right? So the interpretation, if I have to interpret this particular way, that Shiva have punished him is, you know, I will go with the first statement of, like, if this person is not very pure and affectionate in relationships, in marriage, or in devotion, in that scenario, the person will have a punishment. Now, there are two nakshatras which are getting punished. One is Mrigashira, because Mrigashira is luring behind his own daughter, Brahma. And Shiva will come and chop his head. But why you are luring behind your daughter? And right now he is luring Bhaga because Daksha Prajapati is not affectionate to his daughter. Brahma ko dand mil rahi, tujhe affection hai kyun? Daksha Prajapati ko mil rahi, tujhe kyun nahi hai bhai? Right. So the nexus is completely changing. There he is being punished because of affection on the daughter. There, in at this particular place in Uttara Falguni, they are punished because they are not having affection on the child. So, Mrigashira is high affection, this is low affection. But dharmas are just opposite. So that's why they are being punished is what I can make up. So the particular thing is, how I will interpret is it that the debilitation of Venus, like if you are not loving, if you are not caring, if you are not affectionate related to the signification of the planet, which is an Uttara Falguni, in that scenario, you are going to suffer the misery at the hand of Veerbhadra. And Veerbhadra once again means Veera is someone who is very powerful and who can win every fight, and Bhadra means someone who is given to doing good for the world. So it you can say that if you don't respect woman or if you don't become affectionate related to the signification of the planet, whichever is an Uttara Falguni, in that scenario, you can be punished by some good person. You know, that punishment of tune meri dost ka dil toda, to mai tere se jhoota relationship karke tera dil todega type can come. But still, and you know, these things generally be. These things, like, you know, the way I tell it, it is not very, you will like, sir, if this ever happens in life, but it generally does. Like, you denied admission to this guy, and now I will take admission in your course, and I will give the content to this person, and we will make videos together. This thing happened even if, right? This thing keeps on happening, right? So this thing comes from this particular Uttara Falguni. Padas of Uttara Falguni. The first pada of Uttara Falguni will be Leo Rashi Sagittarius Navamsha. Right, so the connection of 1 and 9, the person is fortunate. So if there is Venus, for if there is Venus or 7th Lord, fortunate in marriage, etc. etc. Right. So the first pada of Uttara Falguni, fortunate, given to Dharma, strong influence of father in the strong influence of father, good education. Generally keeps on learning throughout his life in some field or the other. And will get a child late. Generally his profession is very much connected to the profession of his father. Right? The person is spiritually inclined, is into mantra, etc. Generally can also be connected to music, because sun indicates a magician. Can be interested to music. The person is scholarly, will love reading multiple things. Yeah. Love reading multiple things. The after childbirth, life will completely change. Right? The person will have face akin to a donkey. Face akin to a donkey means a face which is, you know, like, which is chubby after this head portion, chubby after this portion, and, you know, like hard on the forehead section and chubby around cheeks is the face of a donkey, generally what is told, right? And a face like a donkey also means nose, which is like, you know, this elongated. So the, like, you know, the holes of the nose are easily visible from the upper area also. Right, and the lips are a big prominent. So you know, like, lips are very prominent, very fat as compared to the rest of the face is generally what is the face of a donkey. Like, see the face of a donkey, you will understand what he wants to say. Aadmi ke muh pe to gadhe ka sar kabhi nahi hoga, but resembling that particular thing, right? Like when we say the face of a horse, that means the lower lip area and this chin area will be very prominent in the face. That will be prominently seen. That is the face of a horse. When we say the face of a nose, the face of a what? The face of a kya hota hai? Tota. The face of a peacock? Nahi. Parrot. The when we say the face of a parrot, that means a very prominent nose. The prominent sharp nose. Aise tote ki naak hoti hai. And prominent sharp nose and small this, you know, mouth area. So the nose is very prominent and the mouth area is not that prominent. So that is what the shape of different animals mean. Aisa. Dekho, jab bhi aapko lage donkey is a wrong, donkey is a bad animal, remember one Hindi poet said, ki koi kehta neech gadha hai, nipat nirakshar neech gadha hai, par swargkar ne jab bhi dekha, swarg ke beech gadha hai. To gadha swarg ke beech mein hai, samajhiye aap is baat ko. Swarg ki duri hota hai gadha. Copy, okay. This person will have dark eyes and he will have long arms, charming legs, and will be troubled by breathing disorders and will be troubled by cough related issues. Generally fortunate in the matters of properties and lands, and given to the worship of Krishna is what we have already talked about. Right, we'll have to struggle a bit in professional life, generally takes wrong professional decisions, and fame and recognition, the person will yearn for fame and recognition, which may come a bit late. Uttara Falguni first pada. quickly going through everything. Uttara Falguni second pada is Virgo sign and Capricorn Navamsha. So that is not a very good thing. First of all, getting infamous because of woman, one. Longing for relationship, which is getting fulfilled after much troubles and tribulations, point two. Bad relationship with woman, three. And supported by the relatives of mother, three. Fortunate in the matters of progeny and sexuality, interested in mantra shastra, learned, intelligent, scholarly, good achiever in their profession, good achiever in their education is indicated. Along with it, the life is professional life is very full of struggle, right? Personal life is almost okay. The person is tall, handsome, charming. He know how to talk, very impressive in talking. Generally should be connected to the profession related to second house, will be related to the profession of singing or movie cinema or finances, etc. Right? Or will be related to the profession of entertainment. Right? Is good in business, but in his first or second business, there will be many hurdles and he will have to shut down his first or the second business, but is generally fortunate in business and will be able to earn good money from business. But initially there will be some hurdles, etc. Right? And if late marriage, then good, early marriage, then bad. Right? And recognition and fame comes after much difficulty. The person should strongly control their anger. Right. This is the result. This is a general result, as I have told you before. If you can expand it to other planets, all the very good, then you are using 100% of what I'm teaching. If you think that, sir, I cannot, just a second, Prasadji. And if you think that I cannot expand what I'm teaching, then just apply it for sun and moon. Then you are using 30% of what I'm teaching, but still you are using. Like, 100% use karne pe reward to main de nahi raha hun. Because that itself is a reward. Yes, Prasadji.
सर बहुत एक ऑसम केस था, बड़ा कोइंसिडेंस है, मेरे पास कल एक चार्ट आया, तो दैट पर्सन इज उत्तर फागुनी सेकंड पदा लग्न में, तो उसका राइज होता है, उनका गुलिका भी वहां पे बैठा हुआ है, ठीक है. तो सर इमेजिन करिए, आपने जो फर्स्ट लाइन बोली ना, इन फेमस ड्यू टू द वुमन, दिस पर्सन हैज गॉट रेप केस अक्यूज्ड, रेप केस इनके ऊपर लगा है, और उसके चक्कर में काफी साल तक खूब बदनामी हुई इनकी. But yeah, finally bahar nikal ke aa gaye. So quit.
That's why we are saying na, he is accused, not guilty, or not being punished because of it. Ab gulik hai to bhai, paap phal to fir aram se karega gulik to. Okay, no problem. Complete dand we will give you. So that's what gulika does. The second pada of Uttara Falguni, the person is going to have an eyes like an antelope. Eyes like an antelope is these eyes are very close, right? So the upper part of the nose is narrow and the starting part of both eyes are very close towards each other, is what is indicated by the eyes of an antelope. Right? He will be a good speaker. He will be charitable. He will enjoy physical pleasures, will enjoy conjugal happiness, will be rich, dark complexion, and will be large-hearted, will be philanthropic, and will be very good-hearted and good-natured. The second part of Uttara Falguni. Right. The third pada of Uttara Falguni is Virgo Aquarius. First thing first, life is difficult because the Rashi and the Navamsha 6-8. The person is very talented. Everyone thinks that he will be able to do multiple things, but all that talents, etc., will only start working after 30, 35. Before that, the life is very miserable. The person has to struggle in a multiple things and no one is going to support him, not even his family members. Even if they want to support, their support is not enough for this person. Right? the person will generally marry either an elder lady. If the lady is not elder, then lady will remain diseased. If she is neither elder nor remain diseased, then divorce pakka. Then divorce 100% sure. Okay. And the person is intelligent, learned, but a bit dull witted. He can understand things better. He can understand things well, but to implement it, he will need some time. Generally, a person who goes by experience rather than going by the normal stuff, right? Generally, fortunate in terms of finances will have a good family. Will belong from a like affluent, good, rich family. Will be loved by his family members. Generally, will be either the eldest one or the youngest one in all the siblings. Right. Generally gets money through inheritance as well. And in matters of marriage, the person is not very fortunate. He will have to compromise in one aspect of marriage or the other. Right. The person have a tendency of hiding things, and the person will be quite a bit secretive. Yes. The person is very self-centered, works for himself. The professional life is like professional life or personal life, whatever be it. The starting part is full of struggle. After crossing middle age, there will be some relief. Right? Marital life is very disturbed, and professional life is very less disturbed, is what I can say. Along with this, the person is, fortunate after the birth of the child. Before that, the person is quite unfortunate. He will have a charming face. He'll have charming eyes, will be fair complexion, will be soft, argumentative, fickle-minded, and will be pot-bellied. Because that is what comes with Aquarius Navamsha, right? So pot-bellied. For the third pada of Uttar Falguni. The fourth pada of Uttar Falguni is Vargu Rashi Pisces Navamsha Lagna Lord Debilitated. Okay, like the Rashi Lord Debilitated in the Navamsha. So, health problems, diseases, troubles, miseries, struggles in life, like will not be able to understand things properly. Generally will do wrong decisions because he haven't understood something properly, and because of this particular reason, he will have to do the things again, right? Fame comes late in life. Despite the person being deserving, he's not. He will not be appreciated. He will always be underpaid, under-evaluated. Right. Marital life is good. Professional life is also good. The rise to success is easy and quick. But to maintain that rise and maintain that top position is a bit difficult. And the person will create problems while, making a decision. Generally, one, two major decisions of life are wrong. And because of that, there is a strong suffering. Right? The person is given to comfort, and as comfort will increase in his life, laziness will also increase, which will result a decrease in professional status or a setback in the professional life. So despite the fact that person will be able to achieve easy ways to comfort, he should not give himself to comfort, is what I will say. Right. Being the third Navamsha, life is a bit difficult. Life is filled up of struggles, etc. And disease is something very important and prominent that I will say. The person is clever, intelligent, should do business or should be in the profession of teaching. Business and teaching will suit this particular person. Wife will be talented. Wife will be devoted. Wife will be a bit chubby, bit fat. But devoted and religious and intelligent as well. There will be blessings in life after marriage. Before marriage, the person will have to struggle for multiple things. People take undue advantage of this person. People take advantage of this person in multiple ways, and he is generally deceived by many people. Right. Along with this, the person will have a flat type of nose, or it is told that his nose will be burned, which means the person will be falsely accused of something and he will not be able to ever come out of that accusation, right? So that false accuse will, disturb his image throughout the life. He will not be able to prove himself innocent, which he will be, right? He will have a prominent feet, long arms, pure and good speech, and he will be fair in complexion. He will be friendly. After time, he will also gain weight. Yes. And generally, things in his life is repetitive. So in the first relationship, if the first relationship ended with fight, then second, third, fourth, fifth, all the relationship keeps on ending with the fight itself. There is a particular pattern that he can observe in his life, and that particular pattern is there. It's a general result. If sun or if moon or the lagna is there, if Venus is there, then it is a repetitive pattern in marriage relationship. If the Mars is there, then it is a repetitive pattern in your decisions. We take Mars for anger, but there is something very prominent that Mars should be taken for your ability to take a decision. Mars is your understanding of what I should be doing in this particular situation. So this is what Mars does. Right? So the result for all the four padas of Uttara Phargani. And I think that you have understood it. You have made notes. We'll start with the next nakshatra in the next class. Yes, Sonati.
वही third pada का जो बताया आपने वो एक साल में divorce हो गया मेरे एक उनका जानने वाले का है मेरे पास chart उनका एक साल में शादी के एक साल में उनका Jupiter है उत्तरा फाल्गुनी में और एक अभी जो फोर्थ पदा का बताया कि उसको जॉब में उसके प्रोफेशन में ऐसा कुछ गलत इल्जाम लगा उसकी वजह से उसको जॉब छोड़ना पड़ा ऐसे दो तीन अभी आपने बताया मेरे भी पास उत्तरा फाल्गुनी वाले ज्यादा है 5-6 चार्ट में है तो वो सब दिख रहे थे मुझे वो बताना था बस
ये 0-2 ज्योतिष में आप लोगों को पढ़ाऊंगा विस्तार से टेक्निक जो मैं करता जाता हूँ इस पूरे में Zero to Jyotish me karunga isko aur aram se ye bhai bumper this is a bumper technique if you get the crux of it na I use it every very every day like button you don't have to think on this particular thing and if you are good with basics you can quickly make it like I am doing it and if you are even not good with basics you will just at 15-20 minutes and you will be quickly able to achieve it and this particular thing I am going to teach this blank chart prediction the course. So Amarkanji Unnati Jisto invited there. And this blank chart prediction course is like, if you want to really get into the root of how I do this particular thing, that will be there in blank chart prediction. Yes. But once again, in my course, you will need three things, dedication, devotion, and patience. Oh, if you think we will go through the course of Swamsar, or we will take one class, we will become astrologer. No. Dedication, devotion, patience. डालोगे तो काम होगा वरना नहीं होगा राइट सो नेक्स्ट नक्षत्र नेक्स्ट क्लास राइट थैंक यू